in relation to crimes of a massive scale. The chamber sentences the accused, Nguyen Chi, to life imprisonment. The chamber sentences the accused, Kyu Sampon, to life imprisonment. Given the gravity of the crimes for which they have been convicted and subject to any order of the Supreme Court chamber, Nguyen Chi and Kyu Sampon shall remain in detention until this judgment becomes final.
I was 10 when they killed my father. My sister was only 17. She died of forced labor. Another sister, her husband and her four children were killed because her and her husband were a university lecturer. My brother was separated from his family and killed. My sister's son, who is born during the Khmer Rouge regime, lost his father when he was only 1 year. I lost 35 family members and close relatives in 3 years, 8 months, and 20 days. They were never accessed to the fair trial.
Today, we want to shed light on the question if justice has finally come to Cambodia, or if the judgment was too little and too late.
The chamber in the verdict came down with a lifelong imprisonment for both the accused for crimes against humanity. The most part of the judgment revolved around the expulsion of the population from Phnom Penh in the beginning days of the Khmer Rouge regime in 1975.
ការកាត់ទោសមួយជីវិតនោះមានន័យថាជនរងគ្រោះគាត់មានអារម្មណ៍ពេញចិត្តណាស់ទៅហើយប៉ុន្តែអ្វីដែលគាត់គិតថាវាជាតម្រូវការចាំបាច់និងជាភាពចង់បានរបស់គាត់មួយទៀតគឺការពិតដែលចេញពីមាត់ជនប្រព្រឹត្តដែលជាអ្នកមេដឹកនាំជាន់ខ្ពស់នៅក្នុងរបបខ្មែរក្រហមព្រោះអារម្មណ៍របស់គាត់នៅតែមានភាពមិនសប្បាយចិត្តខ្លះខ្លះដោយសារការប៉ັດមិនត្រូវបានទម្លាយចេញពីមាត់អ្នកគ្រប់គ្រងនៅសម័យនោះ
The two accused are facing very very serious charges and they have a right to basically have a chance to face these charges, to challenge these charges and try to prove their innocence regarding these charges.
Impunity is one of the greatest curses in any society where it is prevalent. The ECCC, through its mere existence and through its rulings, delivers that message loudly and clearly. What we did not see, unfortunately, was a reaction of the Cambodian people who watched the event on TV all over the country. No doubt the reactions must have been very mixed.
ជាចុងក្រោយគឺសូមឲ្យសំណុំរឿង002យើងសង្ឃឹមថាអបតកនឹងដំណើរការបានឆាប់ចា៎ហើយជាពិសេសនៅក្នុងសំណងពាក់ព័ន្ធសំណងសំណុំរឿង002ចា៎យើងសង្ឃឹមថាអបតកហើយនឹងអង្គការជាតិទាំងអន្តរជាតិយើងនឹងមានការកែប្រែនៅក្នុងច្បាប់វិធានផ្ទៃក្នុងមួយចំនួនពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងបញ្ហាសំណងចាតាមគណិតយោបល់របស់ដើមបណ្ដឹងក៏ដូចជាជនរងគ្រោះទាំងអស់ដែរដែលគាត់ឯកភាពសុំទាមទារបញ្ហាសំណងបុគ្គលព្រោះសំណងបុគ្គលជាសំណងមួយដែលថាអាចធ្វើឲ្យគាត់សះជាផ្លូវចិត្តបានមួយចំនួនធំចាពិតមែនតែសាក្រមបានដាក់ទោសជនជាប់ចោតអស់មួយជីវិតមែនប៉ុន្តែអានេះជាផ្នែកទណ្ឌកម្មចា ចាតនកម្មគឺបានមួយកម្រិតពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងផ្លូវចិត្តគឺគាត់អត់មានតនការសះជាផ្លូវចិត្តទេនឹងហើយគាត់សុំទាមទារសំណងផ្លូវចិត្តសំណងផ្លូវចិត្តគឺសំណងបុគ្គលគឺជាសំណងមួយសំខាន់បំផុតសម្រាប់ក្នុងការផ្សះផ្សាផ្លូវចិត្តរបស់គាត់ឲ្យមានការសះជា
When the people who get traumatized in the Khmer Rouge time the way of educate to the children is like a control because they fear of the suffering even current situation of the country you know they don't allow the children to join any demonstration because the previous suffering enough so they could not empower young people to learn about the new thing of the world that is a consequence of the Khmer Rouge
the legacy of the KRT tribunal will depend on what we will learn from what we will do from the from now on the reconciliation not so much onthe verdict I think it's important but I think there has to be more that has to be done to bring us to reconciliation and reconciliation has to start with understanding of what happened
and one thing I'd like to say about reconciliation is that it's not necessarily about forgiveness and I think that's a very difficult and complicated term for us to think about and I certainly wouldn't want us to be thinking thatFor reconciliation, you need to have forgiveness, as for a lot of people, that will never ever be possible nor right for them.
This is a very important judgment. It is, I think, a just outcome for those who are gone and for those who remain. As a prosecutor,One takes joy in the proper application of the law. One does not feel pleasure or pain from these kind of judgments. But I know that there are many, many millions in the country who may feel pleasure, who may feel pain, who may feel both.
The tribunal took so long that it's really creating a lot of people to lose hope whether it has really bring justice to the victims and we still have ways to go but I think it's going to be a very rocky road with our self that has to be I think the to make assurance that thing will not happen again it has to come from Cambodian itself ourselves